Hi, welcome back. I'm Rakesh Naik. Today we are going to discuss about an application of greedy method, that is optimal storage on tape. But before we start, a small request. If you are a new visitor for this channel, kindly subscribe this channel and press the bell icon so that you will get all the notification at the earliest. So let us start. So today we are going to discuss about optimal storage on tapes. What actually it is? The new generation people, I don't think that you have seen any of these kind of tapes. This is a music cassette. This is a video cassette. How to optimally store the record in the tapes? That's what we are going to discuss. And we are going to apply greedy technique to find the optimal storage on these kind of tapes. As you can see, these tapes are sequential by nature. If let us say you are storing some files or song in this cassettes, then after first song only you can go to the second song. Like a CD, you cannot play directly the second song or the fifth song or tenth song. If you want to go to the tenth song using a tape, you have to skip all the nine songs and then you can reach the tenth song and you can play. So this is a sequentially arranged file. So basically what we do, a computer programs are earlier stored in magnetic tapes. When a user wants the program, then he can retrieve it from the tape. And the length of the programs are arbitrary by nature, but let us say there are five programs and the length of each of the five programs are different, but the sum of each of them supposed to be equal or less than the length of the tape. So basically, to write that in a symbolic way, let n be the number of programs that are stored on a tape and li be the length of each. So for ith program, let li be the length of the program and tj is the time required to retrieve that particular program. Retrieve that particular program is, let us say, second program, if you want to retrieve, then of course you have to skip the first program. So to skip the first program, you need some time. So you need time to skip the first program and you need to read the second program in order to retrieve the second program. So we use a concept of mean time retrieval, and that is given by MRT. It is 1 by n summation of j equal to 1 to n tj. So this is the mean time of retrieval for any program. According to the ordering of the program, MTR value varies. According to the order in which we are going to retrieve, the MRT value or minimum retrieval time values will be changing. We'll see how it is happening. There are another constant, that is DI, using which the optimal ordering is decided. So here let us say I is I1, I2, IN. It means I represents the order of the program, in which order I need to keep the program. Let us see this with the help of an example. Let us say there are three programs stored. It means number of programs are n equal to 3. And the length of each program is, for first program the length is 5 unit, the second program's length is 10 unit, and the third program's length is 3 unit. As there are three programs, in how many order, how many ways I can arrange them? I can arrange them in 3 factorial ways. It means 6 possible ordering I'll be getting. So based on the ordering, we'll get the D value. Let us see how we are trying to find it. So initially the ordering will be, I can have the first program first, then second program, then third program. First, third, second, second, first, third. In this way, I can order the program in 6 different ways. Let us see their calculations. Let us say I am taking the first program first. So the first program, if I am taking, the unit required is 5 units. For the second program, it will take 15 units because it has to go through the first program and as well as it will go through the second program. So altogether, it will take 15 units of time to retrieve the second program. And to retrieve the third program, it has to retrieve the first program, second program and third program. So it will take 18 unit of time. So 5 plus 15 plus 18, it will give me 38 unit of time to retrieve all my programs. Similarly, if I follow the order, first, then third, then second, then what is happening? For the first program, anyhow, it will not take more than 5 units of time. For the third program, it has to traverse the first program and after that it will go to the third program. So 5 plus 3, so 8 units of time is required to retrieve the third program. And at last, if you will retrieve the second program, 5 plus 3 plus 10, that is 31 units of time. So similarly, if we carry on working out with all these sequences, I can see 29 is the minimum time that I'll get. So I'll get the minimum retrieval time as 29. And the order in which we are getting, it means if I want to put in the tape the third program first, the first program second, and the second program third, if I put in this order only, I'll get the minimum retrieval time, that is 29. So this is how we are going to apply greedy technique to solve the optimal storage in a tape. Let us see the algorithm. So greedy algorithm for optimal storage on tape. Here, assign programs to tape where n is the number of program and k is the number of tapes. Let us say j I am initializing and it is indicating the tape number. For I equal to 1 to n, because there are n number of programs and the loop is starting with 1, so I varying from 1 to n, I'll write the program I for tape j when j equal to j plus 1 mod k. At the end of this program, I'll be able to allot the optimal storage. So the complexity of the program will be theta of n. Thank you for watching this video till the end. Keep watching, keep learning. And if you like this video, please share among your friends and leave me a comment. Thank you.